Hello, everybody. Welcome back for some more Kingdom Hearts Final Mix. And today, we are going right back into Hall of Bastion, so we're going to go ahead and continue some of the plot. And also, I recommend keeping on Donald and Goofy. I know that Beast is actually pretty powerful, but for the sake of getting the rest of the Trinity Marks, I'm just going to leave them on for probably the rest of Hall of Bastion. Or at least till we get all the Trinity Marks, definitely. In the last couple episodes, as you may have noticed, I did some Trinity hunting and I did some item stuff. I don't really recall me doing anything plot related. I don't think I did, to be honest, because if I would have done it, then, well, I don't know, like the last episode was like 20 minutes, like the episode before that, like episode 37 was like an hour long, so I'm just going to assume that some people probably more likely skipped out on it, you know, probably not giving a crap what happens in that video because they probably already did this game 100% themselves, so it's really like, what's the point of watching it? Or, unless you're just, like, interested in seeing how I go about getting the Trinity Marks, then I guess somebody would have watched it. But anyway, nonetheless, we're still back in Hall of Bastion, of course, and, I think... See, I'm missing three blue Trinities, which I have a feeling that those three blue Trinities are probably more than likely somewhere in Hall of Bastion, because I have yet to find the rest of them. If I end up not getting all three here, which there may or may not be three here. Because usually, like, when I first played this game, I remember I missed three. And I remember finding a couple of them, at least in Hall of Bastion, so I don't know if there's actually going to be three or not. But if there was, that would definitely help me out a lot. Because if we beat Hall of Bastion without all the Trinity Marks, I'm just going to go ahead and go find the last Trinity Marks and just go get them. The good thing is, I think there's a yellow. It's either a yellow or a green. I want to say it's a green. There's a green somewhere, and I know that there's a blue in Hall of Bastion, I know that for a fact. Then there's also, well, I'm trying to think of what else I'm missing. A red, yeah, there's a red upstairs. And most of it's actually pretty much mandatory that we need to do it. So I have no excuse for missing out on those, to be honest. So anyway, this is a pretty basic puzzle. All you need to necessarily do is find the correct little book, and then when you find the correct book, that's when, you know, the bookshelf should move. Now, I don't know why Sora decides to go ahead and spin this entire thing around just to get this one chest, but he does anyway. So, if you find these pillars that look like this, make sure you spin it around. That way you can actually hopefully find something good out of it. Not every single pillar in this room is going to have one, but for the most part, I'm sure you'll be able to... Yeah. Well, speaking of Trinity Marks, here's the first... I think... Well, the first green Trinity Mark in Hall of Bastion, but I believe it's also the last Trinity Mark of the green ones that we have to get. So we got the Azul, Volume 3. So you have to put it in the correct place. This is the N one. We need the ones in the A section. I think you can carry more than one book at one time, though, too. I believe so. You should be able to. That'd be kind of stupid if you couldn't, but who knows. So we got to make a potion out of that one this time. Last time, of course, was an elixir. Let's grab this real quick. So we got the Mava. If anything, it's pretty much, for the most part, color-coded. So you don't need to worry. Yeah, they actually give you a safe spot here, too, just in case, like, if you need to switch out your party, because, you know, the game's gonna show, hey, you know, freaking, you're gonna need somebody here. Like, you're gonna need, like, the entire party here. So let's switch out, let's put this one here, and we'll switch out the blue one in just a second. We'll grab the blue one real quick, and we'll go put this over here, because this one should go here. I think so. No, this is the... Wait, yeah, this is the S shelf. Alright. So we got that one finished up. That should open up this doorway. The good thing is, if you fall down there, the game will obviously give you the bookshelf to take out so that you can actually move that bookshelf. So they're not going to be dicks about it or anything like that. It's not like, oh, you fell down here, oops. Guess you're not getting back up there anymore. Did we get this? Actually, I don't think we did. No, I think I got the other one. Yeah, we didn't get this one just yet. Again, like I said, I don't know why Sora has to spin it all the way around, because this is why. I figured that was going to happen, but it's stupid why they do this. It's like, I just want the damn book. I think we need to go... You need to do something with it, I know that. Or maybe we just spin it around multiple times and hope for the best. That might be what's going on with this situation. I'll try spinning it again and see what happens. Hopefully the third time's a charm. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on. Thank you! I was going to say, Daddy needs a new pair of shoes. Alright, so now we got a Mythril out of that. Something I'm gonna definitely need later on. Do I not have the end book yet? Nope. And what book is this? T? Oh wait, I had the T's apparently. Alright. So basically, it's just like it was in the last puzzle, where you just keep going, you know, back and forth, pretty much. And that's typically how it works. So we unlock the door, but we're still missing a book, though. And if we get that book, that should open up a bookshelf to get us something that might be a secret or so. Let's try to find that out, and we'll try to find this damn book. Alright. So if you don't get it on the first time, spin it again. You don't get it again, spin it again. Just keep spinning until you get the treasure chest. Because apparently in this game, you need to keep spinning it like a few times before you actually get it. Some of them, of course, not all of them. Which is kind of weird because, like, you would think Sora would just... Oh my god, really? You would hope that he would actually just spin it around like a normal person would. Like, he would just move it. Like, he sees a treasure chest and he would just grab it. But apparently in this game, they do not want you to do that. So now we got an AP up, so... Apparently, since it was an AP up, it's actually more worth it than what everything else we've been getting. Where is that last damn book? I know there's another book somewhere. I just need to find... Maybe we have to go into the next room and then find it there. That might be where it was. Shit. Either way, for the most part, I have an idea of where to go. It's just I need one more colored book. Actually, wait. Hang on a second. Because I know we're missing... Okay, well, so we have a book right here that we're missing, obviously. So if we put that one there, that's going to open up this way. But where do you open up that way? So there's really no point. All that's going to do is just block off that. But maybe it won't just block off that. I don't know. We're still missing the green one, though, too. I'm sure it's around here on one of these shelves somewhere. I assume so. If anything, well, yeah, hell. Here we go. Here's one. All right, so let's take a look around again. We still have the blue ones in place, so they're good to go. What color was this one again? Green? Yeah. And we're missing, I think, this orange one or so upstairs. Whatever color it is, yellow, orange. Yeah, this color right here. Alright. So yellow-ish, so we're missing the end book. There we go. It's like yellow-orange-ish. And that should give me, yep, oh, there we go. See, the green book. So we'll take the green book with us. And I think these blue ones right here, it's probably, yeah, I think we're missing a blue one, of course. So now we need to fly back down there and go put in this one over here. So it's a relatively easy puzzle, nonetheless. But it's just a matter of, you know, back and forth, grabbing this, grabbing that. And of course, we'll grab this book, and that should be the last one that we need. So awesome. So we got the Hefet volume number 4. Good thing is, like, they tell you the volume order, but you don't necessarily need to know that because... The only books you need to know that for are the green ones downstairs with the Mava. But even then, like, it's color-coded on the bottom anyway, so you'll figure out, like, three here, three there, three there. So everything should be good. So this is going to be the lift shop, so let's go in here real quick and see what's going up here. Because this should take me to some extra nice places. You see that chest up there? To get that chest to come down, go ahead and select Gravira or Gravity or whatever you would have at the moment. And then use gravity on it, and it should knock it right back down. So we got 97, 98, and 99. So we got the last of the Dalmatians. But that does not necessarily mean that we have all the Dalmatians. I'm not going to go to the lift shop just yet, because I think that we need to go do some other stuff first. Before I start heading to the lift shop. So let's go ahead and get whatever's behind door number one first. So this is going to take me to the entrance hall. Which is going to lead me to another puzzle piece to the heart. And we have a red Trinity Mark right here. So this should technically be the last of the Trinity Marks of the red one. That is. So that's going to be that piece right there. That little... I know where the blue is actually at. I know where two blue are at, actually. I'm just thinking about it on top of my head right now, where they are. Let's just say, actually, the stone is etched with the thunderbolt. Okay. So we're going to hop over here. And... Yeah, you can't really do anything with this, I guess. Let's see here. What? This takes me back to the library. I think that's the only door in this room. Besides, of course, if we go back down here, we'll grab this. It'll be the first emblem piece that we have. I think we're still missing, like, a couple emblem pieces. Let's go put in the door and let's go find out real quick how many emblem pieces I'm missing. So we got the first one. We got the bottom piece. And that's it. Yep. We're still missing three more. So the other three are going to be around Hollow Bastion somewhere. It's just a matter of finding it. Now... I just want to say that Hall of Bastion's probably going to be at least a few more episodes long. Like, I mean, it might be a few more episodes before I actually get it finished. And then after I get it finished, I'm going to head back, try to complete all the mini-games I can, and try to complete all the cups that I can for you guys, and then hopefully get some Super Boss stuff going. So, and, you know, if I do, like, any, like, item, like, grinding for items and stuff like that, or just trying to find items, yes, I do see that chest over there, by the way. Well, like I said before, that's going to be done off-screen, because I don't want to have to torment you people, you know, into watching me do this Let's Play for days and days on end. Now, my guys, they had a Let's Play that went on for, like, 60 parts. So, and when I say my guys, I'm talking about the Super Gaming Brothers, of course. They had, like, a Let's Play that went on for, like, 60 episodes. I know I talked about them a lot, but I really do look up to them, to be honest. In terms of, like, Let's Player, like, YouTuber-wise, pretty much. You know, their Let's Play of Kingdom Hearts went on for, like, 60 parts or so. So, they did it for, like, a long time. But I guess apparently we can't come up here because the game won't fucking let me go across and get to the stupid other platform. Wait. No, that takes me in here. Okay. So, yeah, now there's literally no point in doing that. Problem is, you can't skip it either. Or there actually might have been something I needed to do. If there was something I needed to do, then I would have done it. Well, that's the problem. Okay, come on, game. Really? Seriously? Just hurry the hell up. Like, I don't know what... If there's, like, any specific button I probably need to hit or something like that that might change the path. We'll find it. We'll figure it out. Don't worry. It's a lot easier in Chain of Memories to deal with this section because you don't have to put up with this kind of shit. But yeah, see, like, all this stuff, like, just blocks it all off. These little things right here, I don't think that Beast can just knock them down. See, that's another thing, too. Like, you kind of need Beast to, like, break stuff, too. So, maybe I should probably just go grab Beast real quick. Go equip him. And just in case I need him, then we'll take him to our advantage. You know what, I'm gonna go on that lift one more time. I want to see something real quick. I want to see if there's, like, a door that I might be missing that, you know, only Beast can break down. Because I might not have seen that, because it from what it looked like to me, it looked like there was no other way we could go. But I'm sure with some definite inspection, we can probably more likely find our way to go. Thing is, this my Let's Play so far has only reached, like, 39 parts. Thus far. I'm sure more likely it's going to hit over 40, and it might even hit over 50. So, it's going to be quite the big Let's Play, folks. It might even be bigger than my Paper Mario Let's Play, for all I know. Like, Kingdom Hearts is not a long game, necessarily. Like, you can beat it in about... You could, if you just ran through it just completely, you could beat it in about 15 hours. But, that, you know, again, that's where the trophy thing came from, too. Is like, you can beat it in about 15 hours, and, you know... Yeah, it sounds like it's easy, but to me, I have not done that yet, so... People say play on beginner. You know, that way you don't have to worry about, like, a whole bunch of shit. So I guess this was nothing, because I can't seem to get over there. Because the problem at hand is... Yeah, I can only go so far in this room. Yeah, it completely blocks me off. So the chest over there, the way to get to a lift at. So I guess all this was for... was a treasure chest, which I would have forgotten if I didn't go over here, to be honest. Now, where the fuck do I go this time? Alright. I know I need, like, 3 emblem pieces. So what I could do, I could head back outside of the castle once again. We're not going to head all the way down back to the... Wait. What if we do go all the way back down to the water thing? Yeah, I'm going to grab Goofy again. And we're going to head back down to... what's that place? The thing with the elevator, like in the dungeon, there was that elevator thing. I want to go back down there real quick and check to see if maybe I could probably take that now. That might work. We'll find out. We'll find out one way or another. All right, so let's go ahead and switch him out for Goofy. Yes, please. Thank you. I don't know why they give you the option to switch who's in front and who's not. Like that, I just don't get that at all. Like, I don't understand the reasoning behind that. Okay. So what's these other ones got to say about this? This one was a lightning thing that's about it, so... Yeah, the stone is etched with a thunderbolt. I'm gonna try something on it real quick. I wanna see what happens. Well, if I shock it, then it's gonna give me. Oh, that's right. So there we go. We got that figured out. All right, kick ass. So now this should go ahead and hopefully. Wait, I don't think it lifts me up. I think it just lifts me back up there. Yeah, I think it's just an easier way to get back up there then. Oh, well, damn it. Alright, well, either way. We're gonna try to head back outside real quick to the castle gates. See if I can find anything else that we can do. Hopefully. Like, the puzzle here isn't necessarily difficult. It's just you just gotta find the right stuff. You gotta find the right buttons to press, and that's about it. There's really, like, no, oh, you know, you press this button and it will change something completely different. Well, I think there's like a few of them that might do that, but... Or maybe like one or two. But as far as I'm concerned, there's nothing. Now, getting up to that fucking thing is gonna be a little difficult, because now I have to get up there. But, the problem being, I can't get up there. Wait, I wonder if these actually work. That one works. Oh, so yeah, because like now we have everything working. Maybe we can get everything now to work out here. Okay, so sweet. Yeah, using Beast would probably be, like, the best option, of course, for these guards. But, I'm not gonna have Beast on because of the simple fact that having him on is gonna take away from me getting Trinity Marks. And I do not like that. Now, would you freaking use Gravity, please? Thank you. Thank you so damn much. Alright, so. These fucking shadows, that they just go away. What do I want to do first? Let's find out. Now, this is not turned on, apparently. No response from that one. Let's click on this one and see where this one takes us. So that's probably going to take us down. That's going to take us down. I don't necessarily want to go down. I want to go back up, actually. Oh, this takes me back here. Okay, that's right. Well, granted, this is where I was wanting to go anyway to check on that elevator thing, too. So I do and I don't. Like, I want to get this over with as quick as I can, but I want to go find out whether or not the elevator thing... Oh, we got some new Heartless, though, too. I think to get the Heartless actually coded in your book, you have to kill them. So, we need to go back and take down those new Heartless that we have spawned over here. Okay, so first things first, let's go find that stupid elevator thing real quick. That's right, we gotta take, like, every damn bubble we see, of course, no surprise. So, I want to say this now. I may or may not have a whole lot of episodes during the week, so just be prepared for that. That there might be, like, some downtime during the week. So, if, like, you see me not uploading, don't freak out, because... More than likely, I'll be right back up to it. But yeah, see, there's a blue Trinity Mark in here. So we're going to go ahead and get that one. That's going to be the like, third to last one we need. Alrighty, so far so good. Let's kill these assholes. Okay. Yeah, gravity is definitely one of the best options against these shielded enemies because it just knocks out their health completely. I recommend doing it on them. Like, I don't have gravity as Quixelette because... It never became useful, pretty much, until now. So, at this point in time, I was like, yeah, I'll just use it. Alright, so there we go. Now we have two more blue Trinity Marks left to go, and that should be about it. We need to find a way to get up there, though. But the problem is, I don't think we can get up there just yet. Because if I remember correctly, this doesn't really lead me to anywhere, specifically. Like, I don't remember this actually leading me to anything at all. But I do recall there being a chest somewhere. So if anything, I can go ahead and try to get this chest that I saw last time, and hopefully that'll work out. It's funny, because like, okay, this is like totally off topic, but this is recording-wise. So I was going to record like earlier this morning when I woke up, right? And as soon as I was going to record, that's when the weather started getting pretty bad. By the weather getting pretty bad, I'm talking directly about, you know... Freaking, like, it's storming like shit, and, like, thunderstorms and everything like that going on, and it just wasn't very fun. And, you know, I don't want that kind of stuff to pick up in my commentary, because it could easily destroy my commentary, necessarily. Like, it would just seem a little bit more unprofessional, and, you know, I'm totally about being professional, right? Yeah. But, no, anyway, so, when the storm stopped, you know, I went out and got something to drink, and I came back, and as I came back, I was going to move my shelf, which is what I record my mic on top of. I have like a computer shelf I have on my mic. So I moved it, and my dumbass decides to go ahead and tip it over, and then when I tipped it over, that's when the entire thing just like completely fell down. And Everything on my shelf fell down except for my mic, because I was holding on to it for like dear life. I was making sure that that damn thing would not get away from me. So, let's see what this does again. I don't remember what this does, actually. No, that just changes that, so there's really no point. Shit. Well then, what does this button do again? Oh yeah, it just raises up this door right in front of me. So not a big deal, apparently, I guess. Alright. Well, fuck me then. Okay, well, I'm trying to figure out where that stupid button was at, or where that chest was at, because I know there's... I just want to check on this. So yeah, as soon as I picked everything up, which wasn't a whole lot of stuff, to be honest, but I eventually picked everything up, you know, off my... or I put it all back on my shelf and what have you. I went to go sit down, and when I went to go sit down, my chair started tipping over, and I about fell off my chair. So... that would have sucked at... wait a minute, hold on. There's something right there, too. Oh, maybe we have to change all this. Because, like, you see... oh, yeah, no response, because we got the gates open. But we need to change these. Oh, yeah, that might be something, too. Let's try that again. Let's go back again real quick. I want to see something. I want to know how to get this damn chest to work, because maybe we have to change some specific things around, because there still might be something that we need to go ahead and incorporate real quick. It would definitely not be that button. This button only changes the back buttons. So if I change those back, and then I move forward, maybe, just maybe. Actually, what does this button do, to be honest? This button raises up that door. That's right, yeah, it closes that one off. So we don't want that one to be closed off, obviously. That one needs to be opened. And the button right there, to the right, is the one that closes off the back door. So let's go ahead and take care of that. I saw that I didn't have any MP. I saw that I'm losing MP. I thought I was losing health for a second. Like, what the fuck am I losing health for? Now, this button over here, all this button does is just raise the platform. So, that's all that one does. Thank God. I'm going to hop on this real quick, and we head back up here. And now I want to check if there's, like, a way I can actually get into that doorway. But the problem is, this gate is still closed off. So, I need to figure out a way to somehow get that damn gate to open up. But I can't seem to figure that out. Let's see. I don't know, like, I can't figure this out. Like, maybe I'm definitely an idiot, I know that much. But I don't think I'm that stupid. I mean, yeah, I don't know. Maybe there's like another button somewhere that I need to press. Or maybe that gate doesn't open until like a certain point, because I just don't remember if it did or not. Again, folks, it's been a long time since I've actually done this. So, in terms of, like, where the button would be located at, or where the gate would be located at, it would be over there. But there's no button over there. That's the thing about it, too. So, I don't get it. Having that open ain't really gonna do shit. Yeah, it's... that's not gonna really matter. Yeah, oh, I see. So, these, like, darker blacked-out versions of these gates are probably the gates that are going to... What it looks like to me, it looks like these kinds of gates. Oh, maybe I can close that one. Oh. You know, I have an idea, actually. Hold on. So if this button would raise down... no, all it does is raise down... actually, wait. I think I have an idea, folks. Hang on just one second. I'm thinking, like, the black gates themselves don't move. And I think that the brown gates move. From what it looks like, the darker gates don't seem to move, though. Now, what fucking button was that again? So that one moves that one. And this one's going to move this. It's going to move this over here. Okay. So now, I need to go ahead and lower down this button right here. Okay. I think I'm getting it. So we lower that so we can open up that. And then I'm going to run across... I'm going to go ahead and open this one again. And then, well, that's a problem too. If I open that one, I can't get anywhere with it. Okay. Yeah, because I need to open that one over there. You see that? Yeah, see, there's this gate right here. But I don't... that's not going to do shit. I want to get this, because there's a button over there too. But I need to get that button, but the problem is... these two gates right here get closed off. So this one opens up this. Clearly, yes. And that one over there only opens up this door. So there's no problem there. Let me try going back again real quick. I want to see something. Yeah, we actually can't go back unless we close off. Son of a bitch. This might be a little harder than I thought. Let me try that one more time. I know I keep goofing around with this. I know I'm not really supposed to be doing this, but I need to know, damn it. I need to know if there's actually technically a puzzle with this stupid door because I can't seem to figure it out. So, like, the thing is, we have to close that one off. Because if we close that one off, we can open up this. And the problem is, if I hit that button over here, it's only going to close. Yeah, there's a button over there, too. What the fuck? Well, what opens that one, then? Okay, I'm, like, totally lost here. Like, definitely lost here, folks. Like, I have no idea what the hell's going on. This will only open. Yeah, this will only change, like, these two. And that's it. Because, like, this will block me off completely. Maybe. Actually, maybe it won't. No, it will, because that door is closed off. With that door being closed off, I can't do shit. Yeah, see, I can't do anything because it's closed. Oh, shit. Yeah, I don't know. I'll have to, like, do some research and look into this because I cannot, for the life of me, figure this out. So, let's go back real quick and maybe try to take out that stupid fucking new heartless thing that we got spawned in there. I want to go take them out real quick so I can get them written down in my journal. And then, in the journal, I'm going to go ahead and read about the journal a little bit. Figure out what these new heartless are. Just so I can get this done in, like, one video, I guess. Alright, let's see here. Yeah, this is the one we want to go to. Not that other one. I'm going to go ahead and look into, like, some research about this puzzle. I'm going to try to, like, look into it and see what I can figure out. Maybe in the next episode or two. Who knows? It's getting really fucking hot in here, though. It's seriously getting pretty fucking hot in here. Like, no kidding. Alright, so now they decide to go and spawn in. Awesome. I think, like, if you're locked onto an enemy, you can't actually leave the area until, like, you're done locked onto them. Like, if you're not locked onto them, you can leave whenever you feel like it. But I think they made it to where, like, if you are locked on, there's... all you have to do is fight them. So apparently they give me, like, a lot of XP, though. A nice, nice bit of XP, to be honest. I'm gonna go ahead and kill them. Yes, gravity does take up, like, a shitload. Yeah, those guys actually need, like, 120 every time, so... that's gonna be the end of that. And, yeah, we got some new characters. Alright, let's see here. Sora needs 3,400 points left to go. Jesus Christ. So anyway, folks, without further ado, I hope you all enjoyed, and we'll see you all next time when we play some more Kingdom Hearts Final Mix. Hopefully I can figure out what to do with that stupid puzzle. And also, if you're going to go ahead and stay here and listen to me blab, then let's get right into this. For the rest of you, I'll see you guys in the next episode. Alright, so let's jump straight into the new Heartless that we have, which is going to be the Wizards. Heartless that attack with various powerful spells that lose enemy attacks by teleporting, making them tough to beat. And that's it for the new characters. So far, damage-wise, we have 84 out of 99. My Trinity list, I'm still missing 2 Trinity jumps. I have all the charges, all the ladders, all the pushes, and all the detects finished. So what's left is just 2 more jumps, which I can easily just... if I miss one, I'll just go look at the video to find where all the blue Trinity marks are at. That way, I just go from there. So, anyway, folks, I hope you all enjoyed, and I'll see you all next time when we play some more Kingdom Hearts Final Mix. And as always, take care, everybody.